Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Let's Play The Binding of Isaac, Wrath of the Lamb Edition. We had some cool runs yesterday, particularly the Doctor's Revenge run. I thought that was particularly cool. So let's try some more challenges. What do we have here? I think Spider Boy looks interesting. Meet Forever. I have a feeling I know what that is. 7 years bad luck has got to be Broken Mirror. I don't know, man. Let's try Spider Boy, see what the hell happens here. Alright, so we start with the Mutant Spider. It gives us Quad Shot. Okay, that seems like pretty fucking awesome. So far these challenge runs have seemed like, we're gonna start you with an amazing item. Not so much a challenge, I guess, but certainly welcome. And I guess this is cool to finally realize that there is indeed a Quad Shot option, in addition to what was previously only a Triple Shot. So this, you know, if I can get some great tier effects used in combination with this, that would be fantastic. Am I crazy, or does this also have a slow effect? Wow, that is super OP. So it quadruples your shots, and also occasionally gives like a slowing, it wasn't a freezing, I guess, just a slowing effect. That is super good. But it's cool because the challenges seem like a nice way to kind of reintegrate myself into the game, because I've been getting my ass kicked. I had a run yesterday that ended in like 15 minutes, which is craziness. Haven't had that happen since like the 10th episode or something. Probably even less, actually. Anyway, we'll just take out our regular version of Sloth here. I would really love piercing shots. I think that would be a fantastic combination right now. Half heart we can't use. Devil, which is great. That's gonna give us max tiers for a room. But we do have no treasure room in here, which, you know, I'm gonna be a little ballsy. Check out what we got in here. We got two pills, please, no health downs. Okay, well, I'll just try to avoid these bombs. And then this other pill, something good, please. Are you fucking kidding me? That's what I went to the self-sacrifice room for? A health down pill and explosive diarrhea? Whatever, well, we'll go in here and get this half hard, get ourselves back to full health. You know what? It's still a worthwhile trade to trade, like, quad shot for one heart container. So that's the philosophy that I'm gonna stick with. We'll get ready for our first floor here. Larry Jr.? No, famine. Okay, well, we'll get our devil card. Ready. This should make us basically impossible to destroy. Famine should be shitting his pants right now, if he was wearing any. It looks like he's kind of wearing, like, a devilish onesie. This is my guess, anyway. Easy enough. We got our cube of meat. Kind of hoping for another health up to, you know, help me survive the next floor, but oh well. I like how the self-sacrifice room can still result in you hurting yourself. That's a nice touch. Like, you hurt yourself to get in, and then the items that you get inside of there hurt you as well. As if the odds weren't already stacked against the player most of the time. That's just downright unfair, man. Alright, we'll murder these guys. I foresee no problems here. I'm kind of interested to take a look at all of these challenges, because it does, like, I think the speedrun aspect of the game is going to be, like, blown wide open now that you can actually start as Dr. Fetus. I feel like Dr. Fetus is the, or Fetus in a Jar, I guess I should say, for being 100% technically correct, is that item that gives people, like, the best speedrun potential. Oh, there's a nickel down here. Alright, we got a single key from that Tinted Rock, because the game is trolling the shit out of me right now. Well, we did get a nickel and a penny in that little section right there. Which is, generally speaking, worth a bomb, especially when I've already got a few of my own. So it's not like I'm gonna be going- thank you. It's not like I'm gonna be going to the shop in a second anyway to, like, pick up bombs for 5 cents. At least not at the very beginning of the game here. I still have two bombs. Not even concerning myself with the secret room most of the time. Let's take it. You gotta be fucking kidding me, man. Troll engines in full effect today. I like to think that every day, like, Edmund McMillan somehow has central control over, like, what is gonna happen in a lot of the Binding of Isaac runs. Like, not like he's God controlling exactly what's gonna drop in every game. Oh, that's good. There's no treasure room again, which is garbage. We might as well go in here. Holy Grail is so fucking good, but I can't get it. It's, like, the best item. You know what? Let's tempt fate. Like, if I'm gonna die, I might as well die soon here, but anyway. Like he has control of, like, a luck dial, and he could be like, oh, is this gonna be good luck today or bad luck? There we go. Okay, that was not worth it at all. I guess I got a single bomb out of it. Well, let's look for the secret room. Because I really want 5 cents. Alright, please, money. Oh, thank the Lord. That changes everything. Okay, so now we will go into our shop here. Whew, okay, we can stop being mad at the game. Holy Grail, now we can fly. That gives us an HP upgrade as well. We got enough money to pay for the Spirit Heart. What up, boss room? I ain't scared of you, Larry Jr. In fact, slowing effect against Larry Jr. is fantastic. I feel like Holy Grail is one of those items that is gonna be like super popular. I mean, not popular in the sense that you get a choice whether or not you're gonna take it, but I mean, popular in the sense that I feel like people really like Holy Grail so far, myself included, because it's like flying. Flying is already super powerful in its own right, and then it also gives you an HP up just in case that weren't enough. Anyway, Larry Jr. died easily. There's a range up to compensate for a range down from earlier. Kind of hoping we run into Krampus here. No, we get Brimstone. You know what? Fuck it. Let's try it out. But I have the quadruple shot. Does that change anything? Quadruple Brimstone, please? Oh, God. It takes 100 years to charge. That must be because I had quadruple shot. That was a terrible idea! Alright, well, let's make our way down here. Curse of the Lost. I forget what that does. I've made a huge mistake. I thought it was chocolate milk and brimstone that sucked so bad. Would have been better off just holding on to the quadruple shot for now. I'm not even sure how I get out of this. Like, how I stop this mammoth charge time. Unless that's just the nerf that brimstone got. Let's drop a bomb here for this tinted rock, obviously. Two more spirit hearts. Those are going to be valuable right now. What the hell is that? Intestine? Umbilical cord. Okay. Not quite sure what that does as a trinket. I was talking to one of my friends. I think he told me that umbilical cord maybe gives you like homing shots, but with brimstone, that's obviously not that worthwhile. Anyway, well, you know, this brimstone doesn't seem that bad. It's just super slow charging, which is honestly probably for the best. What we got in here? We'll exit that room as soon as possible. Definitely not gonna go to the self-sacrifice room just yet. What is Curse of the Lost, anyway? Curse of the Blind is the one that gives you, no map. Curse of the Lost, I have no idea. Has anyone figured out what the fortune teller does yet? Like, that's the biggest mystery of the game so far to me, is when you, like, just get these weird messages. Oh god, they can fly over the holes, okay. You just get these weird messages when you go to the fortune teller, and I'm like, okay, well, I don't want to waste my money on this until I can actually appreciate what it's given me. Okay, there's our shop, which is possibly worthwhile. I mean, I don't have the Steam sale, but I definitely do need a spacebar item. What's this tarot card? 2 of clubs. No idea what that does. I guess that's another mystery for me. Should really visit the Binding of Isaac wiki at some point, because I think at this point, there's just too much in this game that's new for me to, fully understand exactly what's going on. Alright, so we'll take out those two jabronis. Jabroni number 3 and jabroni number 4 here. Easy peasy. Let's see what we got from a boss here. Whoa, never seen this one before. The Blighted Ovum. Alright. Seems like oh god, he's so fast! Oh, thank god I can fly. It seems like a version of, like, Steven. Well, he is dead already. That was quick as hell. That speed upgrade is going to be welcome. But other than that, we'll just continue exploring Catacombs Part 1 here. Brimstone, still OP. The jury's in. So we'll move onwards here. Hopefully find a treasure room. Have I even come to a treasure room yet in this entire game? I'm not sure. Man, this brimstone takes a long time to charge. Almost missed it there, but we'll take this key. No treasure room. Oh, maybe that's the catch for this challenge, is that you don't get any treasure rooms. We'll definitely use this pill, though. Telepills to the angel room. Oh, that's going to be like a free heart container. What is this? Oh, 2 of clubs, right. That's going to be like a free heart container, because obviously we are going to probably get down to the next floor without getting hit. Unless greed was in there, which would have been terrible. Or unless greed is in the shop, I guess. Which is where I'm going to visit next on my quest to hopefully find a decent spacebar item. Well, and that's pretty much exactly what I was looking for. The more things change, the more they stay the same, right? We are basically... Let's try two of clubs, just see what it does. I wanted to see if maybe it gave me like two extra cents because I wanted to buy that extra spirit heart. But oh well, that's pretty much exactly the best I could have hoped for on Catacombs Part 1. So we'll make our way down to the Caves Part 2 with Curse of the Lost again. I guess I didn't do well enough on that floor. Game decided to put me back on baby mode with the caves. That's fine, that should make things, you know, maybe even a little bit easier for me than usual. The only thing that's changed is that Brimstone takes 4 fucking years to charge. Probably as a result of me, having the quadruple shot, is my guess anyway. Come on. Oh, there's a perfect opportunity to get like 4 of them at once there. Let's wait until they all get like bunched up, like right here. Ah, that didn't work as well as I thought it would. How about right here? Yeah, that was better. Alright, so we're doing well on keys, doing well on bombs. And there is the boss room right away, which is kind of crazy. Probably going to run into a Gertie or a Peep right now, but might as well take him out as soon as possible. And as always, I've forgotten that I can fly. Oh, this is the Gertie that doesn't actually shoot bullets, so that should be pretty easy for me. Although it's going to take a little bit while, or a little bit of time to actually get Gertie killed here because Brimstone takes so fucking long to charge. Okay, please just continue charging it. Had to abandon the whole left side. Brimstone, save me! Okay, that was good. That was a good Brimstone right there. That's a good... Who's a good Brimstone? So with this fully charged, we'll just keep taking out the nubs there. Things almost got a little overwhelming right there. Almost. Couldn't do anything about that fly. I need some more crowd control. I need like a Brother Bobby or something. Alright. There is our... Book of Revelations recharged. Jesus juice for range and tears up. Maybe that'll help me charge faster. Parasite, I don't think that will work in conjunction with Brimstone. If it did, that would be fucking amazing. But I don't think it does. Like, imagine if when Brimstone hit a wall, it split into two Brimstones that went, like, perpendicular from the point of impact. That would be insanity. So we do have a self-sacrifice room there that I could possibly visit, like... I do have a fair amount of health, and I'm getting more every 6 rooms or so. Why not give it a try? That bomb's got no chance. Alright, so we'll go in. Oh, okay. I think if you fly, it only does damage on the way out. Yeah, that's what I've... my experience so far. So we do have no treasure room, probably... I mean, I'm kind of trying... I'm exploring both to charge up my Book of Revelations and to verify the fact that there are no treasure rooms when you're playing in this challenge game type. I thought for sure... I mean, it was yesterday, so my memory doesn't last that long, but... I thought for sure there were treasure rooms in that Dr. Fetus run. So maybe there's some other factor at work here. So let's make sure we take out this last guy. Better be thorough. And I... Call me crazy, I think I do charge up a little bit faster since getting that tears upgrade. I think I've gotten Jesus juice in like every single run that I've played so far. We've got a, I don't understand how you get into this room, or like what happens when you do get in. Alright, well I guess you can just fly in, and that is, what is that? Stem cells, health up. That's awesome, I'll take that, and then I'll bounce. See you later. Oh, that stem cell almost took me out. Or not stem cell, that silkworm almost took me out. Got too many medical names for things. I guess silkworm isn't so much a medical name, unless you go to the grossest doctor of all time. The key, this is super easy. I love the... I do read a lot of the comments. I haven't been able to read every comment the past few days, because frankly, like with Wrath of the Lamb coming out, I'm playing a lot, and people are commenting a lot more than usual, so it would be like a full-time job to read every comment. But I like seeing the sentiment of how the game's difficulty is changed by people in the comments. Like, some people are saying, man, Wrath of the Lamb's awesome, it's made the game so much more difficult, like, I don't know what I'm doing anymore. Well, Troll Bomb just actually helped me out a great deal there. And some people are saying, like, man, Wrath of the Lamb is so easy, I was disappointed, I thought it was gonna make the game more difficult, there's too many flying items, too many OP items. For what it's worth, I think I find the game a little bit more difficult so far. It's true that I think, and the more like OP items are in the game, the easier it is to kind of get at least one or two of them to make your life way easier. That might not be true from a mathematical standpoint, but bear with me. But I think, like, the new enemy types in the new areas more than balance it out. What we got here? Necropolis, okay. So we got a lot of asshole dudes here. Oh, almost got hit by that little chub. We'll definitely toss a bond out here, and I will open that golden chest. For the worst tarot card I could imagine. I suppose there are worse tarot cards, but the tower is one of those ones that I feel like I maybe use it once every, like, 10 runs. And maybe use it effectively, like, once every 20 runs. Like, sometimes I will just use it to try to, like, there'll be a tinted rock, but I'll be out of bombs. Please charge faster. You're killing me here, Smalls. Let's try to get all birds with one stone there. That was perfect. And now, out and around. So, I'm glad that we didn't run into the Depths XL here. Although, I think there's been a patch. If you noticed in that Samson video, like, or, yeah, it was the first Samson video, that, I ran into, like, the Depths XL, and then I fought Mom as my first boss, and then it's like, surprise, you can't actually leave the room now. Like, you're stuck, so you have to restart, or kill yourself somehow. It's Book of Revelations. But there is a Wrath of the Lamb version 1.1 that came out yesterday, and my guess is that was probably what it fixed, maybe among other things. Because there has been a little bit of, like, technical problems, I suppose, with the game so far. It doesn't work on Mac at all, which is pretty shitty, I gotta say. I mean, I don't own any Mac products, but I feel for you guys who are like, cool, Wrath of the Lamb's finally out. By the way, I guess no one ever told you, because no one knew that it just doesn't work on Mac, at least yet. But hopefully that has or will be fixed as soon as possible. I think that would be a good guy move. Let's go fight whoever our boss is here. Might as well, we're already here. We got war. I foresee that not being so much of a problem. Especially with these two extra spirit arts I just picked up. Alright, well, watch out. This is why he's got his own tower card. I don't need to use mine. And then we'll just fly over the hills here. I guess we do have the benefit of having Brimstone. He still hit me there? The benefit of having Brimstone in conjunction with, like, the quad shot is that I do still get a slowing effect, which is nice. Anyway, there's our cube of meat. We got level 2 meat boy. This is good because Brimstone takes forever to charge. We got Guppy's head, which is bad. It gives you the flies. We have money equals power, which I don't really need. But I guess I will pick up because it only costs one heart. And, you know, you never know. Maybe I'll come across a whole bunch of money somewhere along the lines. Stranger things have happened. Only have 4 cents right now, but money equals power is one of those items that I regret passing up almost every time I pass it up. We'll just keep exploring here, because, you know, free money, and also free tinted rocks, and a chest containing a damage upgrade. Awesome. I can't believe I didn't blow up the tinted rock there somehow. Luckily, I've got a plethora of bombs. And spirit hearts off the screen. Again, I feel like these challenge modes, a little bit imbalanced. Like, so far, at least the two I've done, so maybe, you know, they get harder later. That was bad dodging on my part. I just kind of ran into them. The two I've done so far have been pretty goddamn easy. Simply as a result of the, like, amazing items they give you to start with. But that's cool, though. Like, it adds a little bit of variety to the game. I can't believe I got hit there. That's so bad. Well, there's Book of Revelation, so I got over it. And we've only got a single spider left here. Come on. Come on. Chest contains... Ah, yeah, there you go. Getting a nickel. I feel like the nickel drops are a lot more common now, too. Which is fantastic. The more money, the better. I can't believe I, again, took damage there. So bad. But oh well. I'm pretty much rolling in health and damage right now. And these red chests are always a crapshoot. What do we got here? 3 flies. Okay, I'll take it. Pop open his golden chest, pick up speed and range increase. Don't mind if I do. This is a self-sacrifice room that I want nothing to do with right now. But otherwise, I think it was a good decision to explore the rest of the floor. Now we have a little bit more damage through money equals power. And our current bank balance. So let's make our way down to Necropolis 2 or Depths 2. I don't think it's called Necropolis 2. I think the second Necropolis 4 is just called Necropolis. Anyway, I didn't major in Greek, so we'll see. Oh, we did go to the Depths part too, which is kind of interesting. I foresee this being pretty goddamn easy. Unless these leapers continue to be, like, total dicks to me on every single floor. Sorry, Chubb! That is gonna be pretty goddamn easy. Got another chest room in here with the Ace of Spades! I kind of don't want to kill all these guys, but I also just want to get out of the room. There we go. So that is my new trinket. I'm guessing that increases your luck. And if luck increases your drop rate, then that's fine by me, because again, the more money I get, the more powerful I become. And the more keys I get, and really, like, who out there doesn't have enough keys? Or who out there has enough keys? Who out there has too many keys? Do you have too many keys? Give me a call at Keys for Gold. We'll turn your house keys into gold. Please tell me that doesn't exist. Okay, we got more money. We got Judgment, who I could give my money. But I kind of want to keep my money, unless there's something amazing in the library here, which there isn't. Library is free anyway. You get it? I mean, it's not really a joke. That's just how libraries are in real life. I totally forgot what I was saying there. Anyway, we're going to move on here. I'm going to hold on to Judgment. The reason, of course, being that I want to hold on to my money as well. The more money I have, the more damage I do. And I mean, Judgment has the potential to give me, like, Spirit Hearts. He might give me, like, a Bible or something, but I don't want either of those. I want the Spirit Hearts. I definitely do not want the Bible. I would rather stick with Book of Revelations. I mean, the Bible's okay, I guess. It gives you temporary flying and it kills Mom in one hit. But, I mean, fighting Mom with Brimstone is kind of my bread and butter, if you've seen this any of this Let's Play before. We got, like, a hot pink Eyeless Ooze guy here. You dropped a penny, which is good. I think every 10 cents, your damage increases with money equals power. So getting that 20th cent is important. Could go to the self-sacrifice room here. I don't necessarily think it's a bad idea. Don't think it's a particularly great idea. What do we got here? A missing page. Let's hold on to that. I'll use Book of Revelations. Let's check out what we got here. Yeah, double spiders. Awesome. So we'll take our damage there. And move on. No idea what a missing page does either, but hey, we'll stick with it. That's what this first week, probably like first month of Wrath of the Lamb is all about, right? Experimentation. It's like our college phase. So let's make our way over to the right. Zombies will fall by the dozens. I'm kind of tempting fate. I'm gonna go to the shop here. I wanna run into Super Greed. Everyone keeps telling me, run into Super Greed. You're gonna love him. Ooh, we got the prayer card. But I think Book of Revelations is a little bit better than that, honestly. I understand how to use the prayer card now. Like, it's best to save it until, like, you beat the boss, pop the prayer card, and then you get a health upgrade on every floor. That's really useful. But I feel like Book of Revelations gives you more than one heart per floor. At least if you go to every single room, which is what I've been doing lately. Perfect! Unlimited keys, just in time! Alright, so we're gonna be fighting Mom here. Again, thanks for everyone who verified that, indeed, they did change, the range on Mom's foot, so that it does like substantially wider damage now. Or, you know what I'm saying? The hitbox is wider, which I think was good because otherwise it was getting too easy to dodge. I was getting complacent. All right, that was super easy. We've got our box, and I always forget what that does. Oh right, gives us one of every item. Okay, so we got a Spirit Heart, got a Key Bomb, Tarot Card is the Fool. Don't want it. Judgment. I'll hold on to that just in case. Child's Heart, I'm gonna stick with the Missing Page as my trinket. And Telepills, which... let's hold on to Judgment. And go down to the next floor. That's a decent item, though. I'm not sure how I feel about, like, the box in comparison to, like, a passive upgrade that could actually really help you out. But, it's another self-sacrifice room in here. It's tempting, but, you know, since everything on the womb does double damage, it also scares the shit out of me. To be just, like, feeding hearts away in the womb. Oh, that's good. Thank God it took money equals power, right? We got the ladies shitting out of their butts here. They should really go see, like, a proctologist. Because if there is any blood in your stool, that, you know, not to be alarming, but you should get that checked out. It's probably nothing. Maybe something serious. There's some more money. Again, there's the shop. Oh, it's a library. I'm not sure what book I would really want right now, as opposed to Book of Revelations, which has been very good to me. not just in this video, but in like every single Isaac video where I've ever recorded with Book of Revelations. I don't even have the battery. And it is still just helping me tear things up. We'll make our way up and probably to the left here is my guess. It's amazing, man. I don't even like think about what my hands are doing when I'm playing Isaac anymore. They just kind of go. My brain's just in control of talking, and like my primitive brain, my cerebellum's controlling my Isaac play. I could give a dissertation on like Western expansion right now. Come to think of it, my play might suffer there. And my speech, since I know literally nothing about Western expansion. Well, not literally nothing. For example, it moved from a west direction. Alright, this has been Northern Line, everybody. Good night. Here, I wish these guys would just stand in a line when I actually had brimstone charge so I could take them out more easily. I guess when there's only two of them, kind of no matter where they're standing, it's a line, isn't it? We got here. We got two spirit hearts. That's worth it because I'll lose one to exit the room. Not that I can see my hearts anyway, but try it, buddy. Just fucking try it. Okay, give me a second to recharge, then try it. Meat Boy, please stop shooting at him. There we go. High heart I cannot use. And wow, I just murked that monstro in one single hit. I wasn't even aiming at that one and I killed him. That was super easy. What do we got in this chest? Keys galore. And another monstro. Wow. I feel like I'm pretty overpowered right now. We got two of clubs again. No idea what that does, so we'll just move onwards here. Poison touch. Why not take it? Because I'm just going to bounce out of this room anyway. And we'll come down here into the cyst room. Now, these guys would just stop fucking moving. Everything would be a lot better. Stay still. Oh my god. Okay, stay. Where are you going, buddy? B-Rev is recharged. We should have the boss room, like, yeah, right here. Guessing that we're gonna run into Skolex. Why am I so powerful? Is that money equals power, like, helping me tear these dudes up? We got death. All right. It's gonna give us level 3 Meat Boy, which is, you know, better this run than the Dr. Fetus run, that's for damn sure. Death is already dead. We'll just try to get one or two good shots on his, horseman here. That'll do it! Alright, so there's our third level Meat Boy, which is gonna help us out, maybe. And Krampus, which is cool, because, I guess I'll finally figure out, well, I won't figure out probably, but it'll give us some data to test whether or not brimstone works with lump of coal, which is something I don't know. That's something that's got to have come up in the past. But I'll take it anyway. Does that make brimstone like black now? No, it does not. Which tells me that it probably ignores it. But if it did count like the same way that lump of coal normally works, that would be super cool, because that would mean if I shot something from further away, because brimstone obviously has like unlimited range. If I shot something from further away, then like it would do way more damage than if I shot it up close, which is very easy to do with brimstone. Alright, Meat Boy, you take care of at least some of these guys. Give me a clean outlet to do something. Feel free, you know, anytime now. Go eat this blastocyst, man. It looks juicy as hell. It looks like a nice little wormy Fig Newton or something. Spirit hearts, bombs, and keys. I feel like there is no way we are losing out on this one right now. I think after this video, I'll go back to doing non-challenge runs. Because I think these take a little bit of the randomness out of it, but it's nice to get a look at it anyway. So there's our spirit heart from Book of Revelations. Bad gas, whatever. I'm going to ignore that bicycle card. Bicycle, like the playing card brand, not bicycle, like I want to ride my bicycle. Yeah, so like I'll go back doing some normal runs, because I think this takes away a little bit of the randomness element that makes Isaac so fun. But it was good to check out what some of these are about. I'm sure that I will show more of these on camera as I try to beat absolutely every single challenge, because I guess when it comes to the Binding of Isaac, that's just the kind of guy I am. Fistula here, I'm amazed at how much damage I'm doing. Like, this is even more than my average brimstone damage, that's for damn sure. And we're in Utero 2, which means we will be fighting Mom's Heart here. And this might be the end, but I feel like, I don't want the challenge to fail, because it gives you that chest after you beat Mom's Heart, or it lives. Or at least it did in the fetus video, the fetus run I did last. But I kind of want to take this run to the cathedral, or Satan, I guess. know. I guess we'll cross that bridge when we come to it. If we fail the challenge because we did more of the game than they expected, that's okay. And you know what? If we get to the cathedral, maybe we'll get a chance to see the real ending of Isaac. Again, if you missed it, I have beaten the game a couple of times, but it hasn't given me the real ending, at least not outside of the stats menu, so I'm looking forward to seeing that for once. Do your job, Meat Boy. Thank you. This is Mr. Boom? I want nothing to do with that. Give me a Book of Revelations, please. And yet another set of delicious, delicious cash. Which will help me just continue growing my damage here. Don't go anywhere. There we go. Book of Revelations recharged again. It seems to be recharging so quickly. Range upgrade that is, 100% meaningless, but also doesn't really hurt us. Unfortunately, I feel like I've gone the wrong direction. So we'll just head up and to the right. I'm really amazed at how much money I got after picking up money equals power on like the second to last floor. I'm not sure which floor that was. I think it was the Depths Part 2. It might have been the Depths Part 1, which is a little bit less crazy, I guess, but either way, it's like, you'd think my best money-making days would be behind me, but no, I've amassed almost 50 cents since then, somehow. And I'm holding this judgment card just in case I run into serious problems, although that is probably highly unlikely at this point. That was easy, and Spirit Art's just dropping like crazy, too. It's a little bit unfair, I feel. Like, to the game. I kind of feel bad for the game right now. Okay, Revelations recharged again. That can't be right, like, it's recharging too quickly. Take out both of these lasers. I predict an easy run. It should be Monstro. Monstro should die in one more Brimstone. Or less. The only problem here is making sure that I've got my shit charged, which is honestly an issue. But so far so good. Mom's Heart is basically dead. One more. Yeah, that was super easy. Okay, we got Spider Butt appearing in the basement. What just happens if we go down to the next floor? Let's do it. Curse of the Lost on Shoal. We will, I guess, try to beat Sade. Now, I was kind of hoping to go to the cathedral, but I guess that option wasn't open to me for whatever reason. But that's fine. We'll just keep it up. We'll try to beat it and get the real ending to the game. Maybe not. Maybe real ending is a derogatory way of putting it, but the new ending, shall we say. Because I don't really feel like I'm in a position where losing is an option. I'm just getting too much health too fast. Even if I started taking like 2 hits per room, I would probably still survive. Get a lot of, oh wow, that was a good shot, Loki. Congratulations. So we'll try to just take out, yeah, there's the last one. Oh, no, Meat Boy is doing work. Slowly doing work. Full zombie room. You never go full zombie, man. Revelations is recharged again. Again, we could go through like 100 different rooms here and we'll still probably make it to the boss, okay? And the fact that I'm being so cocky, let's get out of here because we already discovered that's a dead end. The fact that I'm being so cocky makes me think that, you know, somewhere that is Santa Cruz, California home, Edmund McMillan is cranking up the troll engine right now, being like, oh. You thought Satan was tough? Okay, Super Satan. Super Satan level 4? I don't know, and I don't want to reference Dragon Ball Z in these. That's a painful period in my life that is now long behind me, and I would rather not drag it up and revisit it. Alright, let's get all of them at once. That was lucky, and obviously we will visit the mob trap room. Whoa! So we got the tick. I thought that was a big nutsack. Or, okay, let's not go crazy. That'd be like an average size nutsack. Kind of abuse the range advantage on the laser there. I mean, use it if you got it, right? Troll bomb, so we'll exit this room and never come back. There was a penny in there, so I mean, that would give me a little bit of extra damage, or at least put me on the path towards getting a little extra damage. But it's probably meaningless at this point in my Isaac career. As was taking that damage, like, it just doesn't matter to me, man. This Book of Revelations is recharging so goddamn quickly. Alright, let's work our way towards what inevitably is going to be the final boss here. This has been a surprisingly long run, considering how easy I've had it the entire time. Like, I've almost never felt like I was in danger. Fortune Teller? No idea what that does. Gotta look that up before that becomes useful to me. I'll skip that tarot card, because it's unnecessary. Again, my cockiness could come back and bite me in the ass. I'm just running into flies to kill them. Hey, there's another spirit heart. Let me guess, another two here. Oh. Ooh. Is that Ipecac? Ipecac Brimstone. How the hell is this gonna work? I don't think it does anything, which is probably for the best. Wow, I didn't think it could hit me from that range. Hey, Judgment. I got another one of you stored in my pocket. What do you mean, officer? Okay. I thought this was America. So I feel like Ipecac just doesn't do anything for us in this situation, which is probably for the best because I don't want my shots to explode directly in my face, which is what they did in that Ipecac video I had earlier. Man, I'm starting to feel like my hearts aren't going to be off the screen too much longer. There's some more money. So goddamn easy. The Fallen even doesn't stand a chance, and he's supposed to be one of the most difficult bosses in the game. Revelations recharge. We got Chestception and Sad Onion, which gives us tears up. Not sure if that's going to make us fire any faster. Steam Sale! Second to last room in the game. Perfect opportunity for that. Awesome. Okay, let's fight Satan here. It's been a little while. Drop his bomb down. Basically kill him in one hit. Oh, that I thought that was going to take him out. I would have bet, you know, bet my bottom dollar on that one. Again, Mii Boy, anytime you feel like chewing on Satan, you just go to town, buddy. This has been one of the most overpowered runs I've had in my entire life. This is incredible. Yeah, just fucking try me, dude. Every hit does, like, 30% of your health. Oh, God, recharge faster. I'm trying to do a speed run here. And there we go. That was super easy. Let's watch the ending. If not, I promise you we'll go to the stats menu and we'll watch the new ending there. So far, seems basically the same, but maybe there's been an addition to it here. Or perhaps not. Nope, okay, let's go to the stats menu. Ending 12. Okay, that's the new one, I think. And there's my stats for everyone who's always wanted to know. Here's the new ending. I'll shut up. Alright, perhaps implying that, you know, maybe Isaac sees himself as sinful and is having thoughts of suicide. I don't know. I'm not about to analyze this game. I'm just here to play it. But as always, thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next time.